ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st annual Passover. All I
ever wanted. This is crazy, y'all. We in the arena. Okay, I can't explain to you the level that is. Back in 1985, I came into Israelite School of UPK. There were 20 wooden chairs on the men's side. And those chairs weren't even filled up, less on the women's side. Now, we are at the arena. This place is going to be packed with the children of the Lord shouting in one word and one name to them all.
On Thursday, April 9th, 2020, at sundown, we're going to be holding the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
I ain't a people pleaser, I don't like people either. I don't care if your Nas or Jigga ain't wanna meet ya. Just give me my motherfucking check if we do a feature. Tell Michael Jordan he can keep his fucking sneakers. Walk inside your favorite church and just drop your preacher. Cause he ain't gonna drop the right shit that he should teach ya.
But what about Obama?
Nigga, I don't like him either. What has he done for us?
We're gonna be located at the Westchester County Center, 198 Central Ave. White Plains, New York, 10606.
Diamonds in the cars. They got million-dollar houses. Have you seen ours? See, we get mesmerized and fail to recognize that they don't sympathize.
$100 for all adults 17 and over. Kids are for free.
But they'll be sleeping in that same place when that semi.
Start sending in your funds today.
You continue to delight in mocking the truth of this Bible. You continue to mock the simplicity that it is, as if something is funny, as if the bloodshed is funny, as if it means nothing to you. Your brother and sister being taken away from you, man, and you still want to hold hand in hand? You're simple, man. We can't sit here and continue to be some simple Negroes that don't understand the truth of this Bible, man, and what is being done to us, man. Black students and Hispanics have been seeked out for annihilation for 400 plus years, man, and the Most High still stuck with us, man. Read that from the top.
How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity, and the scorners delight in their scorning? And fools hate knowledge.
And fools decide to hate knowledge, man. What is knowledge according to the Bible? We're not talking about your 2 plus 2s. We're not talking about how good you can add or subtract, man. Knowledge according to the Bible is the law, statute, and commandment, man. You understand how long you want to mock these law, statute, and commandment, man, so you can have your lustful fun, man. Being American is simple, man. For any black, native, or Hispanic, if you want to be American or think you're American because you were born here, that's simple, man. That's absolutely simple, man. Read it from the top.
How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity?
I'm going to tell you right now, my entire speaking, that's going to be my main question for every black man, man. How long is the question? How long before you sit here and grab you a flyer, sit here and get down with your brothers and sisters so that another black man does not have to die the death of Kobe Bryant, does not have to die the death of Martin Luther King, does not have to die the death that every Christian faces, man? Let me tell you something. Up in the ISUPK, we do not die the death that a Christian dies. We do not die the death that a Muslim dies. Do you understand? We are not faced with them same things. Why? It's nothing mystical, but because we follow the truth of this Bible, man.
That's right.
It's nothing mystical, man. It's up to us to bring this truth back to our children and back to our youth, man. We can't continue to be simple. You understand? We're going to get some more. Give me Ecclesiastes 77. You understand? We can't continue to be simple, man. I'll tell you who's simple, man. Every brother that's not walking around here with a long face after a 12-hour shift. You understand? Got accused of something on walking home because they had no car to drive. They're walking home, minding the business. The brother's minding their business, the sister's minding their business, and they getting pulled over, pressed down on the cement, talking about they can't breathe, man. The scriptures say that oppression maketh a wise man mad. Now you see Gayle King. Does she look mad to you? Would you call her wise? Martin Luther King, he died with a smile on his face because all that white chocolate he was getting, right? Right? I don't even like white chocolate. That don't even mix with me. You understand? Oppression maketh a wise man mad. So you look at T.D. Jakes and Al Sharpton and Farrakhan, man. And then you look at the brothers that you see before you today. Do they look mad as us, man? Do they look mad? And they do they look oppressed as every brother that you see here behind this border here, man? You got that? And every brother everywhere, man. You understand? The ICBK worldwide, the conditions that the black people suffer from are worldwide. You understand? Any hood or project across the face of the earth, I guarantee, or reservation, or barrio, I guarantee you it's nothing but black citizens and Hispanics, man. Living in oppression, because guess what, man? We are so simple, man, we don't understand that this world thrives off of the chaotic things that go on in the black, native, and Hispanic community, man. You got that? Read them.
Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 7. Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad.
Read that first word one more time.
Surely.
Maybe.
Surely.
Slightly.
Surely.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad, man. Surely oppression is going to make a wise man mad. We are mad and we do not sit here and joy over any death of any black man, of any Hispanic man. We don't joy over that, man. Wicked or not wicked, man. That's my brother and my sister, man. And their death has to mean something. And they should have learned something. They should have known how to protect themselves. They should have known how to guard themselves. But guess what? The Christian church failed them. When they got locked up in America, the 2 million black men that are locked up in America, when they got locked up and they came out Muslim wearing a dress, guess what? They got failed too, man. They got failed too. They worshiped in some Arab religion when that is not the religion that their forefathers worship, man. You understand? That is not, and that's another thing. It was no religion. It's our heritage, man. We can't be so simple to neglect the black history that's in this Bible, man. February is 1 month of black history. February is 1 month of black history. Black man, you cannot sit here and level yourself to the making of a peanut. Like, George Washington Carver? You can't sit here and level yourself to an invention of a peanut. You have to understand and not be so simple-minded to understand that we built America. We built every kingdom that's ever been great on the face of this earth. So what are you doing leveling yourself to an invention of a peanut? February is Black History Month and is a spit on what Christ did and the sacrifices that he made for black citizens and Hispanics. You understand? 1 month. The ICBK been sacrificing months since 1969. And you talking about 1 month. Christ was sacrificing months every day of his life. And you talking about 1 month. Black man, we can't be so simple to just say, oh, Black History Month. It's time to throw my Black History stuff and attire. Nah, forget that, man. Christ had his Black History Month attire on all day long. The priests and prophets that follow him and before him and after him, which is in the ICBK, we wear Black History all day long, man. Read.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad, and a gift destroyeth the heart.
You understand? Gail King, you a bribe, man. Your heart was destroyed, man. You a bribe, you got that money, you got that check, and you turned on your brother, man. You turned on your brother so quick. The brother, the prophet earlier brought it out so smoothly, so eloquently. You understand? Because it's so crazy how we are so simple that we'll turn on our own brother or sister, man. Skip Harvey Weinstein and the rest of them, man. We gonna talk about this and this and this and this. But forget the oppressor. Forget the oppressor what they doing. They just let them get all squeaky clean, right? Let them get all squeaky clean. When America is dirty, man. Dirty. Give me Proverbs 27 and 12. We gonna give you some more, man. I hope this gets stuck in every black man and black woman's ear for the rest of their days, man. And I hope you take it home to your children because they need to hear it, man. You can't tell them what you feel. You have to tell them what reality is, man. Because reality is gonna hit them in the face no matter how old they are. Reality gonna hit them right in the face and they're gonna be looking left and right wondering who was supposed to warn me of this.
Right.
Who was supposed to tell me that this was going on?
Right.
That this is what was going on, man. You got that?
Proverbs chapter 27, verse 12. A prudent man foreseeth the evil.
A prudent man. A wise man is going to foresee the evil, man. A wise man is going to see that this right here, this is destruction. This right here is destruction. He going to say, I was not taught this. He's gonna say, I wasn't taught this. Any brother that you see back here, guess what they gonna do? Read from the top.
A prudent man foreseeth the evil.
You understand? Every brother or sister that's in the ICBK, man, we gonna foresee that evil. How we know we gonna foresee that evil, man? How is it? Because we wise. Where do we get that wisdom from? From the scriptures. And not just from reading them, but being taught from them from the priest and prophet of the Lord. From the knowledge in the from the knowledge being passed down for Commander General Hunter, man. From the men above us, this Bible is about order. This Bible is very militant, man. This Bible is about black niggas and Hispanics not being so simple to not understand it, man. This is your identity, man. This is where you come from. This is what we died for. This is what Christ gave his life for. Christ ain't give his life for you to turn around and be simple, man. And love being and love simplicity, man. Read.
And hideth himself.
Uh-huh.
But the simple pass on.
But the simple do what?
Pass on.
But the simple pass on. The simple see the evil and they say, nah. Nah, I'm going to go ahead and keep going. Of course, they're not saying it word for word, verbatim. But they going right into where that destruction is at, man. They going right into that snare. How long are we going to continue to be simple to fall into America's snares that we know are plotting on us, man? They know they put the drug in your neighborhood and they sitting on the corner lurking in our neighborhoods, not in Beverly Hills, but in our neighborhoods, in Southeast, South Chicago, Philadelphia. You understand? Lurking in our neighborhoods. Waiting for you to touch the same thing that they put in your neighborhood to destroy you, man. You understand? How simple that we gonna be to get our sisters out of the abortion clinics and understand that that's our babies, that's a treasure, that's an inheritance of the Most High, man. How simple we gonna be before we understand that, man? Where you at?
You got more than
that? And are punished.
And are what?
Punished.
Read that, but the simple.
But the simple pass on and are punished.
And are punished, man. It ain't no if, and, or buts about it, man. The scriptures say the wages of sin is death. You go that way, man, you're going to get punished, man. You walk past this flyer, you're going to get punished, man. Not by us, but by our oppressor, man. You understand what I'm saying? We forget the definition of a father, man. The Most High God of Israel, which is the 12 tribe chart right here, man. The Most High God of Israel is a father. Just like you discipline your children. You didn't really give your children the whooping or the disciplinary action. They gave themselves it because they were being disobedient. We put ourselves in slavery. We did exactly what it is that America wanted us to do, man. And it ain't just this captivity, it's every captivity we've been in, man. We gotta sit here and hear reality for what reality is, man. The ICBK been bringing out reality since 1969, man. Straight up and down. Drop that. Give me Proverbs 27 and 17, man. Let me tell you something else, man. You can't sit here and build yourself up off of being simple. You got a problem in your relationship, call a line on the ISUPK. We got a city wherever you are at. You got a problem, whatever you're dealing with, call the ISUPK, the Israelite School of Universal Practical Knowledge, man, because we going to sharpen you up. Back here, we built with straight up and down iron, man. We built up with iron. Ain't no simple Negroes over here, man. You understand? Ain't no Martin Luther Kings over here, man. That's going to lead our people into a burning house. That's going to lead our children into a burning house. That's going to let our children hold hand in hand with the person that might shoot them when they get older, man. Or if they get older, man. Read.
Proverbs chapter 27, verse 17. Iron sharpeneth iron.
Iron do what?
Sharpeneth iron.
It ain't say simplicity sharpeneth simplicity, man. Iron is what's going to sharpen iron, man. What is going to sharpen your brotherhood? What's going to sharpen the defense system in our neighborhoods, man? This Bible, man. The ISUPK, man. We're going to give you everything you need, man. The scriptures say that wisdom is a defense, man. The scriptures say that wisdom is a defense. Right here, we are taught and trained on that wisdom, man. And shalom, brother. You understand? We sit here and we are trained on this, man. Every black, native, and Hispanic. The scriptures say from generation to generation, our children are supposed to know these things, man. From generation to generation, ain't nothing done away with, man. This whole Bible is one truth.
That's right.
The whole Bible is one truth. Ain't no picking and choosing. We not back here picking and choosing. That's simple Negro stuff, man. That's what your Christian pastor do to make sure that you make it through your day. We've been here since 1969 to make sure your children make it to another day, man. Come on, man. Read on.
So a man sharpeneth the countenance of his friend.
Read that from the top.
Iron sharpeneth iron. So a man sharpeneth the countenance of his friend.
That's right, man. We gonna sharpen you up, man. We gonna sharpen up that countenance, man. We gonna sharpen you up. We gonna clean you up. We gonna take that Christianity off you. We gonna take that Muslim mosque or whatever it is off you, man. We gonna take that Islam mosque off of you, man. We gonna bring you back to your actual identity, man. Because you deserve it, black man. What are you gonna tell your child when he asks, "Where, daddy, mommy? Where am I from? Where do we come from?" You just gonna tell him what you think? You think it's gonna be colored? The African American? The African or the American? Which one? We the real Jews of this Bible, man. We the real Jews on the face of this planet Earth. What, they just disappeared? They just disappeared? Ain't no, we are not African, man. All you got, all we, back here, man, we read, man. We read books, man. We got every information to back up that this Bible is 100% true, man. Everybody invested in it. Everybody across the face of the earth has this book, man. Everybody wants to be us, but these curses only fit us, man. Deuteronomy only fit us, man. The dietary law, Leviticus, and the destruction that's gonna come from going against it only fits us, man. The high blood pressure, man. You understand? The diabetes, man. This Bible is nothing but a black book, man. This whole Bible is black history, man.
That's right.
You could go on Google all day long and click the refresh button and get a million different results, but here's all the results that you need, brother. Straight up and down. That's all the results that you need.
BK presents the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
Yo, this is crazy, yo. We in the arena. Okay, I can't explain to you the level that is. Back in 1985, I came into Israelite School of UPK. There were 20 wooden chairs on the men's side. And those chairs weren't even filled up, less on the women's side. Now, we are at the arena. This place is going to be packed with the children of the Lord shouting in one word and one name to them all.
On Thursday, April 9th, 2020, at sundown, we're going to be holding the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
I ain't a people pleaser. I don't like people either. I don't care if your Nas or Jigga ain't want to meet you. Just give me my motherfucking check if we do a feature. Tell Michael Jordan he can keep his fucking sneakers. Walk inside your favorite church and just drop your preacher. Cause he ain't gonna drop the right shit that he should teach you.
But what about Obama?
Nigga, I don't like him either. What has he done for us?
We're gonna be located at the Westchester County Center, 198 Central Ave. White Plains, New York, 10606.
Diamonds in the cars. They got million-dollar houses. Have you seen ours? See, we get mesmerized and fail to recognize that they don't sympathize.
$100 for all adults 17 and over. Kids are for free.
But they'll be sleeping in that same place when that semi.
Start sending in your funds today. For booking information, check us out on the ISUPA 51st Annual Passover Facebook page. More updates will be available soon. Last but not least, Israel, Commandant General Yohanan will be accepting the men willing to stand for the Hebrew Academy 2021. If you're a black, Hispanic, or Native American Indian male, and you want to participate in Hebrew Academy 2021, contact the nearest camp leader in your city to see if you got what it takes to be a soldier in the Army of Christ under Commanding General Yohanan. ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st Annual Passover.